Yo, how is it going, my friends? It is your boy. Yo, what's up? It's your boy back with another video. I hope you're having a wonderful day, and if you're not, I hope this video will help you in that endeavor. Today is going to be a tier list of only the captains from the boy Bleach. Yeah, our series Bleach. Tied Kubo's finest work. Okay, so this is basically just going to be just showing how the captains and the scaling change throughout the series. So obviously we're starting with the Soul Society. This is when we're introduced to them. Not gonna be covering you. Or you. Or you. And don't know who these two are. I have no idea. But yeah, besides. Is that Lisa? Okay, besides that, we'll get it. We'll take it. Okay. So obviously in S tier, Yamamoto, strongest, you know, all the statements, nobody's stronger than him, bro, nobody born, whatever. Boy Aizen got the Ichigo statement, how's he a captain and this much stronger than another captain? He doing that to Sajin. So, monster. Our boy Byakuya is guarding 8 tier, the top of 8 tier. Why? He's boxing Ichigo. Ichigo takes down Kenpachi Zaraki. Our boy Renji Ikkaku. Then he goes for Byakuya. Byakuya being unrivaled, bro. Byakuya tossing up these guys, bro. Byakuya is built different, bro. Captain plus tier. Our boy literally beat a captain, trains, gets a Bankai. Like, bro, what are you doing, bro? Byakuya's crazy. Then it's Kenpachi. Then I'm like, bro, weren't you just talking about Kenpachi? Yes. Yes, I was. When he fought Ichigo the first time. But now, this is end of the Soul Society arc, Kenpachi. This thing is a little different. I think it was gonna 1v4 four captains, bro. Ooh. What's up, bro, too? But, yeah, he was gonna 1v4 four captains, bro. I think it's a little different. Insane. But you know what? I'll just put Retsu here. Just off the fact that Shunsui and Jushiro like literally have statements of being scared of Unohana. Unohana being said to be the only one that can like question Yamamoto. And like we do know how strong she is defeating Kenpachi. So she should just be comfortably above Kenpachi at all times, as we do see in the next arc. So I think it's just fair, just by the information we know about her character, her background, and just the fact that they're scared of her, can question Yamamoto, this should just be a testament to her strength. So yeah, Shunsui and Jushiro, they fight Yama. Yama's mad, he's angry, and they don't get Sajin. So yeah, that's why they're up here. Then it's the speed demons themselves, and you might be like, Wait, why aren't they higher? Swiffer would have won, bro. Swiffer would have won it in the Soul Society, bro. Speed Blitz, bro. Double tap. It's over. No. Stop it. Yeah. Yorichi concedes to Byakuya. Concedes. No Bankai. Concedes. Concedes. No. Stop, budgies. So yeah, Soy Phone obviously scales above Yorichi. Literally defeated Yorichi. Yorichi defeated Soy Phone. Defeated her initially, and then she just uses Shinkoden. Yeah, you seen the arc. Okay, so y'all might be wondering why Sajin's up here. So by the way, the reason I have them in B instead of just baseline captain, obviously, our girl is able to escape Byakuya, also able to take down our boy Ichigo, who can block a shot from Byakuya, so I think it's fair to put him in B tier. So why is Sajin here? Because he doesn't really do much, you know. He has a little scuffle with Kenpachi, and then he gets obliterated by our boy Aizen. So you're like, why is he up here, you know? But you have to realize, right, Aizen basically nigh Sajin'd our boy freaking Ichigo, like just low key like bah, bro, like his freaking spinal cavity is obliterated. So the fact that he can be in better shape than Ichigo and be like, hey, Aizen, like, and be raging and all this shit, getting back up, be like, Thousand, what are you doing? Thousand, that's why you're in C tier, Thousand. You wouldn't be in C tier if you weren't doing this. But yeah, that's basically why he's there. I think you can't really put him anywhere besides B, because he's able to get up from our boy Aizen, and then our boy, he's able to scuffle with Kenpachi and should be able to fight Kenpachi. I just don't think that he was given enough time to be able to shine, because he doesn't really do anything. But yeah, I mean, freaking messing around and just moving stuff. Then we have our boy Mayuri. Mayuri should be in C tier, actually. Yeah. Oh my god. But our boys up here, you know, these guys are, they don't have much, really. Our boy Tozen gets one shot by Kenpachi. Not a good sight. So, you know, they're captains, you know, captain. They don't really do much, though. Our boy pokes our boy Byakuya, but Byakuya is weakened from fighting Ichigo, and he's tired, exhausted. And this is a fresh skin. So, okay. Like, that's cool, I guess. He's a captain, and he's boxing our boy Toshiro. Toshiro's forcing him to use rat tactics, though, and I'm like, well, they don't really do much. Our boy wants to challenge Aizen and gets complained. So I'm like, you know, kind of a reach. And then our boy Mayuri gets folded by Let's Steal. So sorry, Mayuri. I have Tozen a little higher, because he's actually does damage like Kenpachi. And Kenpachi has gotten stronger. So that's just the reason I have him at the top of C. Oh my god, dude. Like, they're just captains, dude. They don't do anything. That's just a problem. I'd like this point in time, at least. But alright, let's move on. We have more characters to work with in this arc. This is going to be the Aranka arc. So things do change a little bit. S tier doesn't, but we get added on to S tier. Kisuke, our boy Isshin, and our girl Yorichi, all base Aizen tier opponents. So this is really cool, bro. We have a lot more people getting up to this S tier. Like, as the series is progressing, we're having a lot of strong people into S tier, more characters introduced or more characters being utilized as it progresses, and they're actually top tier, which is fantastic. Honestly, Shunsui and Yushiro just stay in A. Our boy Tozen goes up from C. Woo! all the way up here to A tier, bro. Now he gatekeeps it. Right by him is our boy Sajin. He lost the fight, sadly enough. Tozen surpassed the Espada, so he surpassed these two. And then has a release on top, but that is over. It's over. Might have a video, Tozen versus Aizen, just to show Tozen don't get the respect he deserved. Tozen is a demon. He's a monster. He is a bug. He's a bug. Byakuya Kenpachi fight Espada number 0. Pretty self-explanatory just off that. Our boy Unohana scales to half power, eat Bankai Ichigo. So this really does either put her here or here. So as I've said before, Ichigo is mentally nerfed. So he's not able to put the full, like, he's not able to exert himself in, like, to his full abilities. So this either manifests in him having the spiritual pressure can be sensed, and his attacks are weaker, just like as you could imply from Aizen saying that you should be stronger than this, even though he nearly killed the motherfucker. But it could be alluded to by that. Maybe it's that, like, you know, he doesn't have fangs. Again, saying that, like, oh, like, you're scarier in the Soul Society. Or it can't be sensed at all. If it can, she's up here. If it cannot, it's down here. Alright. So, one. Okay, they're messing with Zero. One, two, three. Our boy Gin gets gains. Oh, yes, sir. Our boy Gin is boxed. He's... Do I put the generals together? He kills Aizen, though, bro. But they're generals, bro. Aizen. But they're generals. But he's Aizen. But Tosin's black. All right, Tosin's black. We'll put Gin with... He boxed... Gin boxes Ichigo. Ichigo can box this guy. He's weaker than Aizen, though. Has to surprise attack him, kill him, but you know. Gin is a monster. I really want to put him in S, but I really want to give our boy. So we have our boy Shinji. We'll respect our boy Tozen with Shinji. How about that? So Shinji can box Gin. He can put our boy Aizen under Kyokai Suigetsu. He can also just say Kyokai Suigetsu. Oh my god. Off the top of my head, I actually don't remember Shinji's release name. I think it's Samihata. It's not Samihata, but that's Naruto. I don't remember it off the top of my head. I tried and I was a fake fan, but our boy does like put him under his Anpakuto ability. But this scene is iffy. Because this can either be like, oh, I'm a base Aizen-tier character, you know what I mean? Like, I'm up here. Because Aizen doesn't know about his ability, so it could be that. And then he cuts Aizen, but then the guidebook says that Aizen isn't touched, which throws this entirely out of proportion. As well as Aizen just quickly dispatching of him, even in that instant. So it's like, well, if it was Aizen, it was an illusion. We know it has to be because he actually got hit and Aizen is stated not to. So it's like, so you got put under his ability and then what, Aizen immediately breaks out, question mark? And then just has him under like Kyokai Suigetsu after learning the components of the ability? Like, maybe? But either way, he does box our boy. He boxes both of them. He does have a holo mask and he does have access to his Bankai. So I'm like, just off that merit, I'm like, you know what I mean. Shinji is a baller. He should just be around this tier in strength. Just at bare minimum. So now we have Rukia. She's not a captain yet, so she's not going up here. And I'm pretty sure I got every. These two aren't captains, but they'll literally just go right here. Kensei would go around here to up here, depending on Guardian. So obviously Kensei scales to Wonder Wise. Our boy Wonder Wise can damage this man as well as contain his like flames. Our boy Kensei can box him in base, so either up here at the top or down here, you know, whichever one or the other. I'll just put him here for the time being. And for the rest, y'all aren't in the arc, but now it oh, Mayuri. I'm putting you down to B tier. You get downgraded. Everybody else just gets gains. You're okay. So you're downgraded, Mayuri. I'm sorry. So, bro, if you're ever going to be mad about me putting this man in D tier, This is the list right here. Okay, Mayuri's in D tier. Okay. So now it's the Lost Agent arc. Mayuri doesn't participate. Soifone doesn't participate. Sajin doesn't participate. Man, I really don't want to just throw away all their achievements, but okay. Unironically, though, Lost Agent arc people get power cliff, so y'all two, done. We don't have evidence of Isshin doing anything. Isshin's done. He's just trash. Garbage. We do know nothing about them in the Lost Agent arc. Obviously, they did get stronger, but by the fact that we don't have anything, and then the Thousand Year Blood War arc happens. What if they just got stronger in a picosecond? Okay, I'm going to put these guys, because we do know from the Thousand Year Blood War arc they are active, and just by the fact that we don't see anything, we just can't say anything. So I'll just put them all in C tier for now, just because they don't participate. All right, they don't participate. We don't know the hierarchy, because if not, the hierarchy is basically the exact same, dude, honestly, because not much really does change. Status quo doesn't really change. Yama would still be at the top. Aizen would still be at the top from what we see in the Thousand Year Blood War arc, because it's not like Aizen does a transformation, because we see it at the end. So I'm just keeping it right here, because then it's right here. Whatever. So there's our boy Kisuke. He doesn't do anything. There's Yorichi. You don't do anything. There's Toshiro, you do something. Sajin is not here. Shinsei is not here. Kensei, get out of here. Irrelevant head. Kensei's in the Thousand Year Blood. Retsu, irrelevant head ass. Kenpachi, okay. Now we have the captains that do something. All right. Here. I have to be fair. Yamamoto, get throat. Get bodied. Okay, buddy. So it's like this, because y'all don't do shit, and then y'all actually participate. Byakuya boxes our boy Tsukishima, you box Giriko, and he box Yukio. So they are all rivals as stated, so I'll just put them all in this. Okay, now for the actual Thousand Year Blood War. So I can do this in two ways, either can't fear your own world, or like just all of it. So I'm going to do just the end of the blood war. So end of the blood war, Aizen up here, Yama up here, everybody else gets downgraded. All right, buddy, everybody else gets downgraded. So Byakuya, Kenpachi, Toshiro, yes, these guys are gods. Yes, y'all are very powerful opponents. So people, gap. It's just funny that like until B tier everything's uneven, but let's get the people that fight the Schutzstaffel in here and who don't. Okay, so this is where we bring in the Zero Squad. I'm going to need another tier. No, stop. No, I didn't want to. Okay, whatever. Okay. Now we have freaking Zero Squad. Okay. Now we distinguish who is relevant from who is irrelevant. Okay. So dang. I did need that extra tier. I'm stupid. I'm so stupid, bro. F tier, bro. That is appropriate, bro. That is appropriate for us to have an F tier, dude. That is appropriate. No. It's just gonna reset it. Okay. Okay. A plus? A minus? Alright. Easy. Easy, easy, easy. Where's Kenpachi, dude? I know I threw Kenpachi away somehow. Okay, F tier, y'all have just become irrelevant. We don't know what you can do, so I'll put you in E tier, firstly. Rukia, we don't know what you can do. Gaddy. Freak, dude. Because this is... Okay, I can't use you, because that makes it can't for your own world. And if I use you... I have to do Can't Fear Your Own World stuff again. Fuck. You know what? This is just dousing your blood work. Alright. This is just Rukia. And this is not Captain Rukia, though. Fuck. It doesn't work, dude. It doesn't work. Whatever, dude. It's whatever. Alright. It's whatever. Got the three. So, Zero Squad right here. They gatekeep. If you're shoot stoffel plus or negative shoot stoffel. Shinji loses to Bambi. Beats Bambi, loses but can affect Bambi. These two die to BG. You're irrelevant as well. No, I forgot you weren't in this circle. So Kensei and Rose, the relevant people, freaking get murdered by Mask. She kills her opponent, but I can't really have like y'all in the same tiers at all, so I'm like, fuck, you know. I'll do it like this, and I'll have it like this. Okay, I think this is fair, because we just don't know. All right we don't. We just don't know, okay? Alright. Aizen, Ichibe, or Boyam. Aizen obviously God Yuha boxes him. Ichibe boxes regular Yuha, dies to regular Yuha. Everybody's pissing their pants and can't for your own world. Oh, base Yama, we're not scaling. So B tier. We're the Gerard niggas. We fight Gerard. He states himself to be the strongest, obviously. Blah, blah, blah. Then it's Kisuke and Yorichi. They fight Asken. Asken is a fucking Chad. He drops this nigga. Helps neg the Zero Squad. Shustafu plus your character. Going crazy. But, yeah. Asken is dealt with by our boy Kisuke. Yorichi also is dealing with them. She loses though, but she's still relative. Our boy then necks him easy, or beats him. If Asken was on this tier list, he would be like slotted right here. All right, buddy. But boom, boom. Retsu, because she is stronger than Shunsui and Ukitsake. They don't train, so Retsu is still heat as freak. Mayuri. Sorry, Retsu. Slides right here. Our boy literally is pre-freaking Shikai Kenpachi. Or like eye patchless Kenpachi. It's pre-Kenpachi, alright? Pernai defaults Kenpachi and then evolves past Kenpachi. Mayuri has Nemoa standard equipment. Yada, yada, yada. Right here. So, fights Lele, kills Lele, his rival right here. Lele murders B, self-explanatory. Alright, our boy Nimaya negs the shoot stoffel. They're the strongest. They're the strongest Quincy. Barely beats, nearly dies, loses, actually dies. Who are you? You don't do anything. You don't become a captain till the very end. You don't get out of here. We don't know. Okay, we don't know. So for the Zero Squad, the scaling can go a few ways. So our boy Tanjiro is in the last place or first place. I would lean more so to last place from what we do see, like when U-Haul pops up, but that is just a play, so maybe he is the strongest. He can't fight Ichibei though. But there's Tenjiro, like her slaps hurt him easy. Our boy Nimaya, literally Zanpakuto creator, next to Zero Squad, is doing all his crazy flips and whatnot, but he doesn't have a challenge, so he's stronger than Tenjiro. Scared of mom. Mom's hurt. Gives meals. Shutaro avoids her. So I'll just put her at the top. Shutaro also beat somebody that he couldn't. And I'll just put it like this, because Nimaya negs the actual, like, everybody. And she gets murdered, but it's fake. You can get the reason off. So Sajin beats Bambi, as I said before. Haxes, loses. BG9. Our boy Asnot gets murdered by Mask, but still is putting hands on him. Doesn't do anything till, like, he doesn't do anything. He hasn't done anything yet, so I can't say anything about him. Like, unironically, like, he might just fuck around and be down here. He's not down here, obviously, but just, like, for jokes reason, like, he hasn't done anything relevant, like, recently, so he doesn't have any scaling, actually. So that's the problem. Either way, yeah, that's pretty much it. I do hope you enjoyed this. You can see, I forgot to save these, so maybe I'll have that, like, just tacked on at the end. But yeah, hope you enjoyed this video. Like, you can see the progression, and like, you just saw my mindset for it. Thanks for stopping by. Hope you enjoyed this video. Goodbye.